Hello. I'm sorry to be the last person between the lunch and the conference, but on the other hand, I believe I have a short presentation, as I was asked to present some example of the building which has been renovated for the energy efficiency. Then I will just present some results we have achieved in the energy efficiency field on the housing, and mainly on multi-apartment buildings. And we have finished with all our finances by now, and we are looking around to find the new finances. So we have had good financial measures. First of all, we have had a low interest rate long maturity loan, a special one, and we have had also grants from Green Investment Scheme. We were able to sell some EUs to Luxembourg and got 24 million euros from that to use as grants for the multi-apartment buildings. And also some municipalities in Estonia have had grants, and we also had technical support from structural funds. We financed energy audits and project design documents. We have had many awareness raising campaigns since 2006, and today we can say that actually our inhabitants who are living in multi-apartment buildings are really aware of the energy efficiency, are aware how they can achieve that, and right now they are actually waiting for new measures to come to do some investments. And for the end beneficiaries, it was always possible to combine all those measures. So if you took one, you also had the possibility to use another one. And just some words for the low interest rate loan scheme, which we had. We were first in Europe to use the revolving fund scheme in housing from structural funds. Unfortunately, we got only 17 million euros from the structural funds from the state, and we had to take additional loan. We took it from Council of European Development Bank, CEB. So in total, we had 49 million euros to give out as a loans. We had two very good partners as commercial banks. It was Swedbank and SEB Bank, who then forwarded or distributed funds to the multi-apartment buildings. And as I said, for today it's finished. And from the Green Investment Scheme, as I mentioned, we had a grant scheme, and from the beginning, when we were developing the scheme, we were thinking, how can we achieve this, that private investors would move from using just one or two measures to complete refurbishment. And that's why we came out with a grant scheme where if you do more, you will get more grant also. So if you do only small things, you get 15%. If you do almost everything, you get 25%. And if you do everything, included heat recovery ventilation system, then you get 35% of the investments back as a grant. And we have to say that it has been working very well. We have got more and more applications for 25 and 35%. So today we can report that this scheme works and the people are going for more and more complete refurbishment. So there are some results what we have. If we say then with the loan, we have invested to 478 houses. It means 17,600 apartments. And with the grant, we have had 461 houses. But if we put them together, because most of them have used loan and grant, then we can say that we have refurbished by now 635 multi-apartment buildings. It means 23,000 apartments, which includes 54,000 inhabitants. It's approximately 1.5 million square meters. In total, we have given out 48 million euros as a credit and 19.4 million euros as a grant. Total investments to the buildings has been 87 million euros, in average per building 137 euros. Expected saving is 39%, which will give us 75 gigawatt hours per year. And we calculated for 20 years, so we are expecting 1,500 gigawatt hours for 20 years with those measures. And just to show you a couple of buildings also to see what we have done, then in 2010 Swedbank started a best practice project for one building, and Credex was one of the partners, and building we took from the tender was this one here in Tallinn. It was built in 66. It's a panel building, 60 apartments, very common in Estonia. And here you can see the budget also. In total, it was 450,000 euros, which is actually quite high. And it was 167 euros per square meter. As it was the best practice project, then the building got more grants as other buildings can get right now. But if we calculate this budget with a usual grant that other buildings could get, which was 35%, and the expected energy saving for this building was 50%, then we can see that actually, even so the whole building was renovated and investment was very high, then even the heating prices in Estonia are still quite low. With those prices, they managed to invest without paying more as they paid before the renovation. So this is actually the result of our special loan and grant scheme. Of course, without them, they couldn't do that. And right now they have a building like this, which is of course much better. And you can see the ventilation is there and they have new balconies. Everything has been done for this building. And then one another building I wanted to show you, which is located in a very, very tiny island of Vilsandi in Estonia. And it was just finished in the end of September was the opening. And this building is actually in a protected area, as to say. So they couldn't change a lot in this building, but they wanted to do it almost zero energy building. And it was very expensive, I have to say, but 1/3 of the budget was for a transport. As first they have to bring everything to Saaremaa, which is bigger island in Estonia, and after that to this small island, only in summer, where the water level is very low, so you can go there with tractor or whatever. So it was very expensive, but the building looks now like this. They have solar panels, they have ground heating, they have wind generator, and they have very special triple glazes and so on and so on. So I believe it's very interesting when you sometimes happens to be in Estonia and in Saaremaa, then you can go over to Wilson. This building will be open to public. And then a couple of more buildings which has been using our grant and loan. I have to say that it has been used in all over Estonia, not only in Tallinn. And we are very happy about that also. And the small buildings outside of Tallinn have made this complete renovation, which is very important, and we like that very much. So just a couple of, as you can see, the investment, for example, here has been 123 euros per square meter. And here only 68, of course, here probably some works were done already before they did this complete renovation now, because otherwise this investment cannot be so low. And to conclude, we really think that those financial measures for apartment buildings have been successful so far. And after the building is renovated, we have a really energy efficient and also a good looking building and healthy indoor climate, which has been a problem before. We have turned out to the, or we have pointed out the ventilation problems. We have regulated heating systems in apartments now, and we can measure them individually. And the value of the real estate is higher. And so far, the monthly payment is at the same level as it was before the renovation. Thank you.
Do you have an evaluation of the life cycle investment payback streams that have driven these investments? And also, do you have an evaluation of the asset value improvement? Those two final points are really important. Thank you.
Yeah, well, we do not have evaluation of asset value improvement. So this is not our goal, and we do not evaluate that. But investment payback time, it depends very much how the energy price will be growing, actually. It has been growing a lot. In the last 5 years, for example, it has been doubled in Tallinn, for example. And that's why we are really not looking so exactly to the payback time. But what we can say that if we are calculating with the energy price we have today and you are doing this huge investment, the payback time is 20 years. So, because, and in the case you are using our special loan where we are fixing interest rate at level approximately 4 for 10 years, so you know this is not going up.
But that payback's only coming from the energy savings.
Actually, yes. So for the people, the change in a monthly burden, there is no change approximately, only the different lines are there. Before you had a higher amount for the heating, and now you have one more line, which is the loan payment. That's true.
Okay.